And we are back to do part two of Memories Don't Die by Tory Lanez. Appreciate y'all tuning in. So, I have succeeded in at least doing six tracks in the first part. Minimize the talking as best as I could, and I'm going to try to see if I can carry that over to part two and do the next six tracks following up. And I need to do this really quick, too, because the third set of the six tracks, or the final six tracks that follow up to this, are going to be pretty hefty and long. So if I can see and sneak in a seventh track in here, I don't know why I'm talking like some foreign language, which is weird. So I'm going to see if I can sneak in a seventh track in this video. If not, it's cool. The goal is six. So we're going to go ahead and pick up where I last left off, and that's going to be track number seven, and this one's going to be titled Real Thing featuring Future. So finally, the two trap, I'm not going to say gods, but basically the two trap icons, in my opinion, have finally linked up together, and that's great. There's one more trap king that I'm hoping links up with Tory pretty much down the road, and we'll see if that happens, but for now, I'm fine with this. Tory and Future finally getting together. I feel like these two definitely go in the hardest on their beats when they use that auto-tune voice. So I'm glad they actually collabed for once. With that being said, though, the first six were definitely great, with the exception of a disappointment in one track. Let's see how the next two, or let's see how the second set of these six songs go. And yeah, hopefully it hits hard. So let's get it. Track number seven. Whoop.
Smoke me, you know they tryna find you. When I get a paper, see your hand is crispy. And I'm my ex bitch, and she sick, yeah. She don't like that, I just put on with you. Fuck it, tell a bitch to bust it. I ain't gonna talk, I can't touch it. She can't suck me all the baby, suck it. She trying to send a snap, baby, time to bust it.
Off that pre-workout energy, just left the gym about 20 minutes ago. In fact, as soon as I just started recording this video, it was about 10 minutes ago when I left the gym. So yeah, I'm definitely feeling this track. I'm probably gonna be missing, there's gonna be a lot of things I wish I could probably say right now about this, but I can't because my stomach is doing all the thinking instead of my brain. So with that being said, it's just a lit track. I love it. It's upbeat, dope. Seasick has come back and redeemed himself. Of course, he had played Picasso Hop on Make the Beat. But yeah, that's that Seasick 808. I'm telling y'all, like, that's what I was missing from Shooters. I needed that 808 bounce. Nobody hits that bounce cleaner than Seasick, and Tory knows he can work that to his advantage. But I don't know, bro. I feel like, and like I was mentioning earlier in the first part, check out the Joe Budden interview that Tory talked about. Like, I feel like pulling back your strength was probably the worst, you know, business-making decision you made, in my opinion. Because I know you're trying to do that for the now, but I think like 10 years down the road, there's some good content that should have been put out during this, during these last 2 years that, honestly, really could have made you more appealing as an artist than where you're at right now. I'm not gonna get into it. You know, I'll leave that for my artist review. But definitely Memories Don't Die is probably the last feel-good project I have about Tory. Just in terms of originality and just knowing that it's Tory Lanez being himself. That being said, no disrespect to what he's got out right now. Obviously, it is December of 2019, and you know, he has come through with a big-time project, you know, aka the fifth installment of his staple mixtape series. I'm not gonna go into details about that, but with that in mind, I still feel like the Memories Don't Die is the last original piece of artwork that I've gotten from Tory. It really is. You know, in terms of originality, you know, fresh songs that really made Tory who he, you know, like, that's just who he is as an artist. And really what made me go lit with this shit. Real Thing is just another exhibit. I mean, it may not be the strongest, like, I feel like, compared to the past works Tory has released, but it is definitely giving, it definitely gives me that reminiscent of nostalgia, and it just feels good. But at the end of the day, though, him and Future was going back and forth on this. It's a lit track, love it. There's nothing more I need to say about it. I'm just happy with this track, and it's definitely a huge hit for him. So with that, let's move on to track number 8, and this one is going to be titled Hate to Say. Let's get it.
I find it funny how niggas start talking money. I'm living lovely, apartment far from the budget. I remember us living not too far from the junkies, the flunkies that try to punk me on corners but never sung me, I swear. In this bitch, and yeah, I'm killing this year. Boys hate it, they gon' feel it this year. I bought a Ferrari, I only drove it at once. I'm moving different this year. I'm leaving thousands, talking millions this year. What niggas really talking? Talk it over. Renegotiated, make the plan, and cough it over. I crossed over like Iverson when he dropped his shoulder on Jordan. I'm feeling more than a sport when you win it. Fuck how they feeling. The feelings got left aside. I told them to step aside. I'm really eating, I'm ordering exercise. You know me. Round the block glow for spitting them hot flows. My scent smell like Michelle was touching my rocks close. Presidential, the flow is so evidential. Like the clear poor customs, I barely show my credentials. Don't need a tenant, I want you to know who's in it. Had me offended last time that I walked in the whole rent room. Let's break it down for them. Yeah. Count this if every show's 100,000 for them. Then that mean 100 minutes on stage would equal 100K. That's 1,000 a minute. So please don't get offended if I walk inside a store and spend 35 in it.
35 minutes meaning spending 35 in it. He just hit you with a double uncharted line right there. So don't get mad if I spent 35 minutes in the store. Which is also meaning don't mind if I spend 35 while I'm in it, which is 35K. I like the way he played that off. Very, very clever.
I like it. Just 35 minutes.
Clever wasn't really the word I was looking for. It was just kind of like smooth, you know? He just came in like a nice smooth little line.
It's a kid who wanna witness my nigga. I'm really sick with this shiznit.
I'm too hungry. Fuck
it. Big Poppy out at the Sunfest. Sean Kingston watched it from the side stage. I made triple the advance that he had gave me in my first year. 45 minutes of me on stage. And I'm not amazed. I think the table's turning. I think you learn from the bridge you burn when you see it burning. I think you learn from the world when you see it turning. I went from being a server to being this platinum deserving, you feel me? Did a song with Meek Melly, called it Litty Really. I just did that shit for the city in love with Philly. Got this chinchilla fur on me just in case it gets chilly. Burning on my side pocket, that's just in case you get illy out here. Me and Travis Scott almost fought at the Malaluna. We both agreed shortly after that it was music we possibly could be doing that's bigger than trying to ruin it. So my apologies, nigga, just forgive me for doing it. History made in New York City. We called a truce at the tower. I only brought a couple niggas with me. The beef was finished as soon as we took a picture. The world was watching attention. The industry started shifting to me. Lord forgive him, Lord forgive him. I was tripping all the time. I spent subliminal dissing just trying to rip shit. Not realizing if I took the time to kick it. And me and Drake mended bridges and probably equal to winning. Got the hard head flow. Money coming so thick, the niggas call it hard bread dough. I'm in this all red foe. See that I'm leaning like the old six foes. I said I stopped freestyling, but fuck it, oh well. A nigga flow so well, I'm like a sampling kit. Give a fuck about who get pissed about my samples and skits. Niggas mad, I'm remixing they shit. Fuck out of here, nigga, stop being a bitch. I think it's time we cut the silence by niggas that's talking violent. Speak of silence and give them coffins and violence plan. R&B niggas with Cisco haircuts, wildin' and stylin' and dissin'. Guess they just tryna go viral.
That right there is a complete and utter diss of Eric Billinger right there. This is the one perfect diss line you could have given him. And it's just funny because I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one. And here's the thing, I listen to Eric Billinger too, and I know for a fact I'm probably not the only person who thought it was weird, awkward, and kind of just downright like wrong for Eric Billinger to just go ahead and dye his natural black hair, try to make it gold. And it was just like him trying to, like, as if he wanted to turn the time back and feel like he was 25 again when you weren't in your 30s. You know what I mean? It was weird, you know, because he was making great progression in his career. Because he went from just making R&B songs to actually making songs about a man being committed in a relationship. You know, the Cuffy Season series. So I felt like that, as well as eventually, like, you know, giving encouragement and hope to people who are out there who are still looking for the one and are, like, just kind of, like, down and they're, like, discouraged. And you kind of give them, like, and in my opinion, too, it was just really his peak during that time in 2015, I believe, when he dropped that. Y'all could be on the lookout when I do Eric Billinger for the next series. I'm going to be doing that next thing. So, but with that being said, though, like, he made songs about anything that has to deal with relationship, whether you're already in one and you're enjoying it, just to give you songs to, like, kind of, like, cherish every moment about it. Or for the ones who still dream about it and still are looking for it, he kind of gave them hope with the mixtape / album eventually. From there, it's just, he really fell off. Like, he went from a man like that to, like, kind of like now one of those grown-ass men that are trying to act like as if they were 15 years younger in a club and shit. Like, who's the perfect example that does that all the fucking time? I mean, Snoop Dogg? Kinda. But at the same time, he knows when to fucking be a grown-ass man. But, like, he's essentially, like, you go into a club and you see a 50-year-old dude and he feels like as if he's 30. That's how I felt, like, Eric Bellinger was making that transition with the little things, you know, the details, a tattoo, like the Easy Call album cover. Like, dude, come on, man. That was cheesy as hell. Probably the most cliche album artwork I've ever seen this dude put out. And that ain't no knock on, like, him in general. Like, it's just everyone's going to have that one blemish that they do. And I feel like that's what it is for him. It's just, why are you trying to act like you're 25? Stop making songs, like, for the single people. There's plenty of artists that do that. You're one of the few that we're making songs about. People who are in love with each other, couples and all that. Like, that's where I felt like, yo, Ariel was at, and really, you really killed it. Your strength was there, and I felt like you should have never abandoned that in the first place. But anyways, this ain't about Eric Bellinger. I feel like, I'm just bringing this up because Tory really brought up a good point. Like, this really goes in deeper, and I feel like him calling out on Eric Bellinger for doing that shit, hey, that was a good point out, you know what I mean? But with that being said, though, the same could be said for you, and I think Eric Bellinger kind of pointed that a little bit up as well in his Yikes diss, which also used the same beat that Tory used to diss Eric. So, hey, that was pretty interesting. With that being said, let's go ahead and finish up the remaining part of the song.
Bella, this your favorite song, this gonna be your favorite song. Said what I'm saying, it's really the people's favorite song. You did.
And I like the fact that he said, this is gonna be your favorite song twice, because that's what really got this beef started in the first place.
Hola, buenas noches, ¿le puedo ayudar?
Can I get one asada and eggs breakfast burritos, please?
Breakfast, asada breakfast burritos?
Yes.
Anything else?
That's it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now, I could have said, poder, no, yeah, no, no, put, no, puedo tiene, no, puedo tener un desayuno burrito, carne asada y huevos con papas y queso. I could have said that, por favor, and she would ask anything else. I would have said this, todo, like, that's it. And my total would have been siete doce. I already heard too many times. What can I say? I love the Spanish language. Speaking of which, when is El Agua gonna come through, Tori? But yeah, like I was saying, he just brought up another point, like another little diss, you know, like that cigarette, like someone rubbing that burning cigarette on someone's chest, kind of like what that guy did in T2 or T3, I forgot, when Arnold walked in. But yeah, that's just Tory elaborating more on to what really started this, and he was just kind of showing like, yeah, I said it twice, nigga, like, chill. That's really what Tory's saying here, and it's true. I mean, yeah, I get that Eric Bellinger has a brand or product carrying it, but, you know, I don't think you have the right to criticize someone for trying to, like, show how much respect to you and kind of using something. I mean, if he says a name drop, hey, you gotta let it go. And plus, you already are kind of, like, messing up your brand in the first place yourself, so I don't think you have the right to say someone is, you know, fag or, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Defendicating, I don't know, but it's essentially like taking away your rights or whatever. I lost the word. I'm too hungry, y'all. Don't judge me. But essentially, that's what I'm saying. Like, Tory was pretty clever with using that. He said, this is gonna be your favorite song. He said it twice specifically because that's what really got Eric Bellinger boiling up, because Tory did use that twice. The first time Eric said, he said he let it go. And this is from an interview that he did with, I think, a TMZ reporter. He said he was cool with the first, but the second one, that's when he was like, all right, I got to tell this nigga something. And he probably had some communication with Tory. And then that's when the beef started. Tory was like, oh, this nigga's irrelevant in an interview. Then Eric Bellinger dropped Yikes to this. Like, it was just back and forth, man. All this, man, all because of one little phrase. Like, you going to act like you don't take someone else's phrase too, Eric? Come on, man. Getting too petty with that shit. But anyways, continue.
If it diss in a flex, I ain't. I could have flexed a Rari and Rafe, but nigga, I ain't. Said I bought my house the other day, I'm flexed in a pay. Real estate, I'm property shopping, bitches probably watching. Got the gadget go flow, no more Soho. I've been crossed by some niggas I used to go toe to toe for. Blow for blow flow, sick enough to eat a blowfish. G5 jet playing goldfish, eating goldfish.
for the record, I did this shit for the hopeless. It's Jova Rose through the hood on the corner while I was homeless as father.
Some real shit right there. He's been whipping and hustling since he's been broke and homeless, man. So that's why I respect this, man. Because the dude he hates to say things that he wants to say off his chest because he doesn't want to come through as being spiteful or ignorant or even arrogant, whatever you want to use. They're two different words, but essentially it's the same, similar path that he's going through with it. But at the same time, he's got to get this off the chest because he's a real-ass nigga. And he wants to, you know, pretty much clear everything off the table. Essentially, that's what I'm getting as a translation of this. So, if y'all got a better one, hey, let me know. But I think mine was pretty good. With that being said, dope track, pretty deep. And I like the way that they use the sample, even though the sample that he used, someone else did the sample as well, and I think they kind of did a better job at it. But I'm not going to knock on play for that. Dope track. Kind of delivers where he needs to deliver. Oh, that's right. The origin of the sample, believe it or not, is from a One Direction song. I shit you not. Go to whosample.com. Type in the track title of this song, Hate to Say, by Tory Lanez. It'll take you to someone else and see where they got that sample. And it'll take you to One Direction. No kidding, no shitting. Check it out. But anyways, I'm ready to get lit. So, track number 9. B.I.D. Tres rojo, por favor.
¿Rojo?
Sí. Tres.
¿Deben los cortes? No.
Gracias.
Gracias.
Hasta luego. And there you go. My Spanish is bad. I'm sorry, y'all, but it is what it is. I'm still trying, and I'm told, like I said, y'all, I'm hungry. We'll get this fixed. Let's continue on.
In a trap with a top and a cash, ay. I won't tolerate a bitch talking back, ay. Now she looking at me throwing that shit back, ay. 20 motherfucking racks on a bad day. Jump. And it ain't no coming back. Pussy nigga don't get in on with the daddy. Sending bullets looking all across the map. See all niggas don't know how to act. I fought on the real body back. Shoot a rock beside me with the green. You gon' let me ride cause I jumped into what the fuck is that. Took a shot at any out of bad. You know it's real, I ain't trying to brag. Crack that head and see it now, drunk, ayy. We don't know you, you can't slow the blood, ayy. Gotta see the ops in the front, but
I got a Glock in my Louis V. Jones.
Jump in the what the fuck is that? Drunk and it ain't no coming back. I might pull up to a block 7:30. If I go once, I know I'll get attached. She mad, I keep pulling all the tracks. Behind over here, but I didn't buy it back.
I'm sorry, but that line, she mad that I keep pulling on her tracks. I am so sorry. I don't mean to bring old spiteful shit up, but that sounds like as if that sounds like what the inside mentality of Jacquees was going through when LMI was pulling all that bullshit on him. That's all I'm gonna say.
This is facts.
She just wanna throw that ass back when I
jumped in the what the fuck is that? Took a shot at any out of bed. Girl, you know it's real, I ain't tryna brag. I just wanna take it to the back. Why you let a nigga bust it down, bust it down, bust it down, oh yeah. Bust it down.
Tell me, correct me if I'm wrong, but like, would it feel like it's natural for when a man and a woman squash their beef that they end it all with sex? Like, I'm just being real, like a dude and a dude, they'll like, move on, whatever. I mean, Drake and Tory took a picture, fuck it. I feel like that's what two females would do if they were gonna squash a beef. I feel like when it comes to two guys, I feel like they would make a record together or some shit. Anyways, I'm not bugging or pressing, but like, tell me what y'all think. Do you think like, if a man and woman had beef with each other, like they would end that beef by pretty much getting it down and dirty behind closed doors and between walls? That's all I'm gonna say. That being said, BID is a dope ass track. If there's anyone out there that weren't a big fan of this track but yet enjoyed Love Me Now, you are the world's biggest hypocrite. But if that's too much of an exaggeration, you are a hypocrite, plain and simple, nothing more, nothing less. This song, I feel like, is essentially the blueprint for Tory's next album, but I like this track a lot more because it feels more Tory related than it does, you know, someone else. But that's a story for another day, or in fact the next episode, which will be Love Me Now. Be on the lookout for that. Oh lordy. But with that being said though, I like Bust It Down. I feel like when you give me a track like this, you know, it's just a nice refresher. I'm not getting this type of track back to back to back for like 8 or 10 rows, you know what I mean? Like, I'm cool with that. And I just like it. It's just a nice refresher after that deep, you know, like kind of like intervention that Tory was really having on a track. He comes back and he's just like, all right, now I got that off my chest, it's time to get lit and get party up, you know what I mean? So I'm cool with that. With that being said, track number 10, 48 Floors featuring Mansa. Yikes, let's get it though.
We can smoke, we can fall, what's your preference? Wrote to Santa just to put you on my sex list. Shoot, got that $1 million, no, not the Craigslist. Oh, yeah, you know who I am. All these bitches in the crib, they just go to the dance. And I'm in another bag, but you go to the scale. We can go to Miami, go, we can go to Santa.
one, but two, you already know that, actually let me give you a real quick review. This first part, dope as fuck. I loved it. I felt like Tory was slipping at first out the gate, but he came in, I mean, he kept running and he was pacing himself in the first verse, came in strong and finished it with the second verse and of course the hook. So that's all I'm gonna say. I'll be right back, y'all. Man, I had to let it go, man. But yeah, loved the first half. That's all I can say. It was really enjoying, like, just to hear it. It was kind of like lighthearted, playful. And then the instrumental was amazing, my God. Like, it sounded like people blowing through, like, those flutes or, like, those tubes. You know, when you have, like, water or, like, the glass filled halfway with water and one, like, three quarters and you try to, like... Or, like, when people be blowing on, like, a jug or some shit. Like, that kind of, like, whistling instrument. That was dope. With that being said, let's go ahead and play the second half. Unfortunately... cringy when I hear that. Sounds like some 12-year-old kid trying to stunt on like a 20-year-old man. Like, calm the fuck down. Like, you're getting way too ahead of yourself, man. You know what I mean? It's like someone who's like a level 5 in a video game trying to like boast and trying to like rub it in someone's face who's already like played the game 3 times full and like at like a level 75 or some shit, you know? Like, calm down, you ain't at my level, boy, kind of shit, you know what I mean? You ain't got that grown man boy, so slow down. Slow down. All I'm gonna say, man, all I'm gonna say about this track is I wish the first part of the song, beat wise and Tory, was extended. I would rather have that, the whole 3 minutes and 38 seconds, than have this. The split, the two half split, I didn't need Mansa was not needed on this song. That second turn of the beat, I don't think it was important. It was cool. You could have maybe made that as an interlude and then just go from there, but I felt like I needed 48 floors to, from the first part, beat the whole part of the song, and Tory just killing it, you know what I mean? Now, maybe you could've got someone else as a feature to help you out if you didn't want to make a third verse. Trey Songz? That could've been a great idea, right then and there. That would've been the perfect, ideal first time collab with him. With that being said, let's get to track number 11, and this one's titled BBWX Fiction. Let's get it. It's gonna be the last track, by the way, and then after that I'll hit part 3.
Yeah, bought a new white race. Last night got a crash. Spinning out on the highway. 720 in the ass. Bad bitch in the passage. Seen the whole light flashing. Ray whipping on McLaren right behind me. Niggas spun right past me. Thank God I'm alive. Thank God, but I probably gotta spend a bank job on the ride. Cost 19K, but that ain't none of my safe. All you rappers ain't safe, let me say it with the bass. All you rappers ain't safe, all you singers ain't safe. First single had me in the crib, put platinum plaques in the place.
Driving that's true, you don't sleep on
club, everything just grace. Grammy nominated on the first album, motherfuckers see the face. Look at me, I know these niggas tripping, these niggas are sugar. Bust down, bust down, bust down, Raphael, what you did to me?
tell me the money is near. We ain't coming out of fast. Keep close, gotta keep hoes by the G code. Got three hoes in the G phone. Got A, B, C, F, G, X, Y, and Z hoes. I'm still ballin' like B Rose. I'm still popping on V Bows. I'm still looking like Ray. Still sipping on C Souls. My dick giant like V Fo. If you need no money, singing in the C note like Do, Ray, B, Five, So, Not, Z, Do. Get it for my niggas back home. In a feed house, selling crack on a trap phone in the crack home. When it's time getting cold, had to go to Bramble League. Still a jacket up about a Jack Jones. Rogers had me getting mad at the phone bill. Switching to the black phone. Yeah, I had to switch to a Tellus. Ain't really shit you can tell us. All of y'all niggas is jealous. Running through the check, money upset. All of these niggas is mad at me. 10 chains by 10 rings. On a nigga looking like swag that I can't keep a girlfriend. Too busy trying to make the bag happen. Cali girl throw back at me in the back alley in a cat that. Yeah, I say bust down, bust down. I throw dick at your bitch. She gon' touchdown, touchdown. Bitch, I'm up now, what now? Fuck about what you saw about. That shit sound like us now. My shit sound like what now?
Praying that my exes don't ever get famous. Or flex on me with a rap or an entertainer. Life in this business come with these different dangers. You rather lie to me, tell me you still an angel. How you still an angel? You be lying, you just fuck some niggas on me and claim you see it from different angles. I see the danger. I find it crazy, shit, I know you as a good girl. Tip a flow, trip a turn, stripper. Last night, call a hot sex, off liquor. Trash bag full of every dollar at the bar. That you willing down to pick up for these niggas throwing it up. You hate it when niggas getting dirty what they want, so hate the reason why you bout to get them Louboutins, so hate the reason why you bout to get your rent paid. Tell them hoes don't shave, they should wear they best shades, ain't it? She gon' make $1,000 on a bad day. 10 hours shipping, she don't never take a half day. Told me dancing was a pathway and did it to the fullest, cause she hated leaving halfway. Hold up, bust it, I can't trust it. Fucking with you got me going way up out of budget. Shout out, this is for the last night before I lost you to the fast life.
I'm gonna say this since there's like 20 seconds of the song. Because this video is about to end. Love BBW, Fake Show, dope ass joint. I think Fake Show just gave me that reminiscence of Lost Cause, the reverbs and all the effects. Kind of wish he had a little more, you know, instead of doing the monotone voice, like sounding like Jay-Z, I wish he would have been like going hard in Lost Cause mode on that. That's all I'm gonna say, man. Deuces, y'all. Catch you around in part 3.